You know, I love sales. I read all the books that come out about sales, marketing, persuasion. I'm a sales trainer. I want to stay on top of my profession. I don't know everything about everything. There's always something new coming. And I listen to other sales trainers sometimes. And I listened to one today. And oh my God, I wanted to reach through the Zoom screen and strangle him. I mean, he seemed like a nice guy, well-meaning and everything, but he just didn't know what the F he was talking about. He was talking about how wonderful his scripts were. Okay. And I said, and you guys know scripts, give me a break. You know, you read a script, even if you're a good actor, it's the same old tired jargon. How can you have one script to fit all sales situations and all personalities? Be creative, be spontaneous. You ever go to a comedy show and see a heckler in the audience? And that the great comedians know how to deal impromptu. They know how to think off the top of their head real fast. You have to do that in sales. And maybe that's not in your personality right now. Maybe that's a tough one, but you can practice and you can learn it. We call it role-playing. I do it with my students all the time. So scripts make you dependent on boilerplate laws. I want you, the great salespeople, they're relaxed, they're calm. They can speak to the quiet person, the loud person like me. They can ask the questions the right way. They can blend in the stroking and nurturing. That was another thing he talked about. He was talking about rapport. Okay. Nothing is worse to me than a salesperson who wants to be my instant good buddy, my instant friend. Okay. It's so pretentious. It's so phony. One of the great words we hear so much about is being transparent and authentic and all that, and organic or whatever, all those other good terms. But when you come across, when you want somebody to, when you're acting too hard up and you want somebody to like you too fast, you're not earning that one thing that we all want in sales, and that's trust. So rapport is important and rapport is good, but using it the right way, how do you get, the question I always ask is, how do you get somebody to like you? Or even better, how do you get somebody to fall in love with you? How do you get somebody to trust you? You ask questions like a concerned professional. You ask questions with stroking, nurturing, empathy. You blend in a little redirection. You stay on the system of agenda, qualification, commitment to close. I know I'm talking fast. It's a New Yorker thing, you know. I've been living in California for over 30 years, and I still talk too fast, but what are you going to do? I get a lot more. My job is to get as much free quality information for you guys in these short videos without boring you to tears, okay? So he was talking about rapport, but he was using rapport in the wrong way. Then he was talking about an NLP technique called modeling. And if they go like this, you're supposed to go like this. And if they ask, have a certain tonality to the questions, you're supposed to have a certain tonality. And to me, that's once again, that's an obvious manipulative technique. Here's the thing, your prospects are not stupid, okay? We're the prospects, salespeople call me just like they call you all the time. We get these voicemails and stuff. Speak to us intelligently, ask questions, find out our needs and greets, find out our problem, remove the pain, enhance our ability to make more money or solve more problems or become more efficient. But if you go into your scripted, hi there today, just reaching out, have you sold that home yet? Oh man. It ain't going to work. And phony enthusiasm too. It's good to be energetic and enthusiastic about your product or service or solving a problem. But you not only have to be a thespian, okay, and act well so that you can make people feel comfortable and get that trust thing going, but you've got to understand human behavior, psychology. You've got to act the right way, listen the right way, and respond the right way. I give all my students a little 3-minute timer. I'm in North Carolina. I didn't bring any with me. Can you believe that? And in 3 minutes, you want to ask the right questions, get that prospect emotionally involved. I'm basically giving you guts 101 here and then just a couple of minutes, because sales to me, it changed my life. It changed everything. I did all the running around. I bought all the new whiz bang books and seminars and all that stuff. And the one thing that got me to financial freedom, that's why we're all here, right? Is learning how to persuade, is learning how to sell to people, is learning how to speak the right way. We're in the words business. I say this every day. We are in the words business. If you learn to speak to people the right way, ask the right questions so that when they, during the conversation, they say, maybe this, guy or girl's got something here. Maybe they actually care. And I do care. I don't want to sell somebody something they don't need or want or can't afford. I want to solve their problems and put mac and cheese on my table. Forgive me. I like making money and taking care of my business and family and responsibilities. And you do too. Because I know you guys work hard. And I know you're good people. You don't want to hurt somebody, and you're entitled in this great country to make as much as you feel you deserve, honestly and ethically, by giving people unbelievable value. But work on your words, work on speaking to people on a consistent level, on a consistent basis. Every day, speak to a couple people. My rule of five, I'll talk about that. I'll bring that up in another video, and you will see magic happen all the time. That's all I do. And I study it, I practice it, and I work at it every day. And nobody deserves success more than you. I really believe that, and you should too. My name is Claude Diamond, 970-281-5151. Or go to my webpage, claudediamond.com. Got a bunch of good free stuff there. And you guys have a great, safe summer, okay? Bye-bye.